stars, Clifton Davis, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Joanne Clue, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
You know why comics do that all the time?
Because it hurts there, that's why.
You know why it hurts there?
Why?
What is it?
Because they got something.
Oh my God, he's got a pacemaker.
No. My liver is in trouble.
Oh, did you like this?
Yeah. Do you remember making a statement on several occasions in this program?
That Tarzan and Jane were never married.
You made that statement on this program.
Right.
This lady from Kansas City sent us a book by Edgar Rice Burroughs called The Return of Tarzan.
Yeah, let me see.
And on the last page, you want to read the last paragraph?
I bet they've just printed it now that I've exposed it.
No, look at the other page there. This is an old book.
Oh, they can
just read it. All right. Read that right there. Is it read that?
And just... so it was arranged inside the cabin that had been his father's, the great Tarzan, Queen of the Jungle.
Lord of the Jungle. Jungle.
Lord of the Jungle was married to Professor Porter.
No, by Professor Porter.
To the lovely Jane. It was then Hazel's turn. That was it. He was a bigamist.
No. Read that whole last sentence.
It was then Hazel's turn with Lord Tennington.
Whatever that means. But anyway. Violet Van Horn of Topeka, Kansas sent that to you to prove that Tarzan and Jane were married. I don't ever want you to make that statement again.
Well, I'll withdraw then. They were married, but they also had affairs with Hazel and Lord Tennington.
I'll get to you later, okay?
I never could understand how our people were there for thousands of years, and this kid could come in one day and just talk to all the elephants, and we went ooba ooba.
If anybody could talk to them, we could, you know?
What do you say to that, Perry Jones?
Amen.
Amen. Okay.
That's right.
All right, we're going to start the audience back right after this message for you. Here we are. Perry Jones has won his first game. He's got his $100 for winning the game. Now he will try for over $5,000. Ready, Perry?
Yes, I am.
How long have you been on the Los Angeles Police Force?
Almost 9 years.
Wow. Terrific.
Is it interesting work?
Very interesting.
Okay. If you win here, you may find this more interesting.
Right.
Right. All right, Perry. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank to you. Hate to say that to a cop, but there it is, Perry. Blank to you. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. $250 if you match the next one. $100 if you go down there with the bottom one there. Which celebrities would you like a little assist from?
Richard.
And the same to you.
Yeah. The same to you, he said.
Thank you. Clifton.
Clifton, what do you say?
Nuts to you.
Yeah, but what's your answer? Don't get smart with me, boy. Okay, that's two.
What was Fanny?
Fanny? Fanny.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. That's good. You have good news and bad news for us, Fanny?
I have good news and bad news.
Oh.
I went to the doctor, and he said that I'm going to have to wear glasses, and I brought them.
No, you gotta get on with it now.
I just want to know which side is the bad news. That's all I think.
See, all right. Now, you've got nuts to you, the same to you, and happy birthday to you. Perry, do you want to choose one of those or think up an answer of your own as the answer?
I'm going with Clifton, nuts to you.
Nuts to you. About two-thirds of the audience think you're right. We'll find out if you're right or wrong, and if nuts to you is up there, and if so, where? May we see the bottom response, the $100 response, the same to you. That's the one that Richard gave you. Okay, we're looking for nuts to you. Here is the $250 response. Nuts to you. Congratulations, Perry. You think Fanny's answer is going to be under the top response?
I think that's the best one.
What do you think? Happy birthday to you. Okay, the audience thinks it's happy birthday. Let's find out what it is right now. Happy birthday, you're right. Well done. Okay. Well, now, Perry, you're up to $350. You're going to play now for $2,500. But to collect that amount, you've got to match one of them head-to-head, and it has to be an exact one. Which one will it be?
I'll try Clifton.
You're going to try Clifton. All right, you face me, if you would, please, sir. Clifton, you get ready to write your response to this. Cool blank. Cool blank. C-O-O-L blank. Put the first thing that comes to your head.
Well, I did, baby, and I'm going to see what happens. I'm ready.
Okay, you're ready. All right. There it is. Now, he's finished. And, Perry, we need an answer from you. What you think will match his?
Get down.
Cool blank.
Man.
Cool man. Cool man. Well, we'll find out how cool Clifton is right now. For $2,500, he says cool man will match you. What do you say?
We were in the same ballpark. It's cool cat, I said.
Oh, you were in the same ballpark.
Same ballpark.
You had cool man? Cool what did you have?
I had cool whip.
Cool whip. No.
Sorry, Perry.
No. Ah, cool whip there. All right. Well, listen, Perry, you got your 350, and you're going to meet another player right now and play another game. You ready for that?
Right.
Okay, let's bring on Judy Jennings. Do I see Fanny Flagg before me here? Didn't you wear one of those ones that Judy's wearing? That's Laurel and Hardy, right?
I'm a little short of Fanny.
It's the same one. She sells them backstage.
Tell us more. Would you tell us about Judy Jennings, if you please?
I'm married to a masonry contractor. We have two teenagers, a 10-year-old and a baby. That's impossible. And I'm very happy to be here.
Well, we're very happy to have Judy Jennings with us here. We wish you the very best of luck. We'll have a go at this game right after we have a go at this message for you. Now we shall begin at the beginning and ask Judy to make a selection.
Be pleased.
All right. Here we go. Burt Park said. Mm-hmm. Burt Park said, I couldn't believe it. In the talent portion of the Miss America contest, Miss Iowa blanked an ear of corn. In the talent portion of the Miss America contest, Miss Iowa blanked an ear of corn. Did you hear that, Judy? Miss Iowa blanked an ear of corn.
Do I have to play?
Yes, everybody plays.
We have a new
first player. Round question, new
That's
game.
Why everybody?
Sorry, Ma.
Right from the top.
Fanny, dear, what's trouble?
I was just that. Just question
Listen,
brought
no,
back.
Just do your thing, Linda. They're all finished down here. We're waiting for you, slowpokes up here.
Oh, I'm all ready.
Miss Iowa blanked an ear of corn.
I know how. Know what the question. Did the music stop?
No. Just slow
no,
down a little.
No, you've gone deaf, sweetheart.
All right, finish that. That's it. Okay, you got it. All right.
I'd
never think of it.
Call me a doctor.
Now, Judy. Burt Park said, I couldn't believe it. In the talent portion of the Miss America contest, Miss Iowa blanked an ear of corn.
Eight.
Eight ear of corn. Ta-da-da. Ta-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. What did you say there, Clifton?
Do you dance?
No.
Will you dance?
No. Not with you.
What? I hope not. All right. I would dance with you if you let me lead.
Okay.
I don't think she ate it there. I think she just skinned it right back. She shucked it.
She shucked an ear of corn.
Yeah.
Good answer. Shucked an ear of corn on stage, slowly, you know, peel by peel, stalk by stalk. What do you say?
I say that little Judy is as big as a minute and full of the devil.
Really?
Yes.
You did do.
And I say, smart as a whip.
Eat a corn. There it is. There's one for you, Judy. Now show them yours.
Peel by peel, stalk by stalk.
Yeah. It was shuck like a strip tease. She shucked an ear of corn, you
and
see.
Shuck by shuck.
Shuck by shuck. Sorry. All right, shucked an ear of corn. That's two shucks and one eight. And what do you say?
I think that Judy's adorable. I like her style and the way she thinks.
Oh, there's another one for you.
Now, would you put the book down, Richard? Richard.
Later that night, Tarzan went to a topless bar.
Topless bar? Tarzan didn't go to the... Everybody was topless in the jungle.
Son of Shucked.
Shucked an ear of corn.
Right. Wow.
All right, so far, all we had is shuck an ear of corn or eat an ear of corn. What do you say?
Oh, Judy.
One from column A, get.
My turn.
No. Yes.
You know, that question makes me very sad. I was in the Miss Alabama pageant 7 years in a row and never won. It's true, because I would become over-emotional about losing and run up and hit the winner. Talent numbers. I did have a great talent number. I played 2 grand pianos while standing in authentic Mississippi mud. But this girl ate it.
Ate it. Ate it. Now, first round question for Perry. Everybody plays. When Fanny Flagg roller skates, she falls down a lot. So she puts an extra pair of roller skates on her blank. Fanny Flagg roller skates. Think about that, Perry. She falls down a lot, so she puts an extra pair of roller skates on her blank. You got the picture?
Got the picture.
All right, we'll ask you in a moment or so for your picture. Hurry up, Gary.
Why do you always rush me? Jeepers. Jeepers.
Coming, Mother.
Okay. Put
Jeepers,
it in a slot.
Jeepers, creepers, America.
Yeah.
Do not delay.
He's always rushing me.
There I am.
Rush.
Here we go.
Wonderful world.
Harry Jones. When Fanny Flagg roller skates, she falls down a lot. So she puts an extra pair of roller skates on her...
breast.
Bazoom, he said.
Bazoom?
Yep.
Is that what he said?
That's right. Apparently she falls forward. I didn't know that. I thought so. That's what he said. Clifton?
I had another answer at first, but then I couldn't figure out how she'd be able to strap them on. So I put down her boobies.
Well... Surprises me, Brett. Life is full of surprises.
It doesn't surprise me at all. The poor little devil is top-heavy. She never falls backward. She always pitches forward, you silly Billy.
Yeah.
I said boobs.
What did you say?
I said Fanny. What
Fanny,
else?
Fanny, there. Yes, yeah.
That's what I thought. I don't know. What'd
you think?
I did, too. I thought it was a perfect play on words.
Yes,
Fanny.
2 roller skates. One on each cheek. What do you say?
That's what you said.
Pardon?
Let me see your answer.
Derriere.
Okay, that's 2 fannies and 2 boobs. What do you say?
Do you realize that the parts of my body have been bandied about upon this
panel? We're banding your body.
I do fall forward, and I fell on my little face.
Put roller skates on your face? You are some dumb broad, you know that?
I always knew she was a holy roller.
Okay, so where are we here? End of round one, scores 3-2 in favor of Judy Jennings. Go to round 2. I push a button and the thing slides down slowly. Judy?
B, please.
B. 3 do not play. Brett does not play. Joanne does not. And Fanny does not. Confucius say, man who make date with chicken... end up with brank on face.
God? Oh, am I glad I don't have to answer that. I don't begin
to Don't say
understand.
What if you don't play. Don't say what, that's all.
Well,
don't say what if you don't play.
Tell me, what are you?
Don't talk if you don't play. Don't do nothing.
Just sit here. Could I go to the blank?
You can't go to brank. Not in the middle of the show. You can't go to brank. I told you, go before we go on the air.
I didn't know Confucius was Japanese.
No, he's not Japanese.
He's but then he's Czechoslovakian.
Everybody heard
he's doing a West Indian accent.
Okay, here we go with Judy Jennings. Confucius say, man who make date with chicken end up with brank on face.
Egg
on face.
Yeah.
I know you're in show business. You're supposed to be funny, but she's pretty funny, too. Oh. She say egg on face.
Egg on face.
What do you say?
Oh, I come close. I try to figure out how the guy, where he had his head, but he got egg on his face.
Egg on his face. Gary, what do you say,
Judy,
old bean?
You're a very clever woman. I wish our writers had thought of that egg.
Oh.
Egg.
All right. Now, Richard.
Do you know he opened the first hamburger hamlet?
Egg. Egg. All right. So. So at this moment in the middle of round two, it's 6-2 in favor of Judy, and your second round question will come along a little bit later. Right now it says here on page 116, you stop for a commercial, dingbat, and pass along this message, okay? Here we go. Middle of round two, gonna finish up here. Now, Perry Jones, you must match four celebrities to stay in the game and achieve a tie. This is his second round question. Clifton and Brett do not play. Everyone else
because
does.
Because we're smart, even though we were poked fun at.
Right. To end with a preposition. One stewardess said to the other, you'd better run into the cockpit and turn off the intercom. The passengers can hear the pilot blanking. Cockpit and turn off the intercom. The passengers can hear the pilot blanking. All right. All set? Okay. Now we come over here to Perry Jones.
Answer, Gary.
Now think carefully before you respond. One stewardess said to the other, you'd better run into the cockpit and turn off the intercom. The passengers can hear the pilot blanking.
Snoring.
Snoring.
Got to match everybody. Got to get four snorings to stay in the game. Gary, does he match you?
Oh, yes, he does.
Yes, he does. There's one, Gary. Now the ball is in your court.
You want a home run?
Yes.
Okay. Snoring.
Snoring. All right, Gary, that's two down and two to go.
There are always two pilots, so that wouldn't concern me if I heard one of them snoring.
No?
When you hear him praying that you're in...
Then you're in trouble. Judy Jennings wins the game. What you have, baby? Congratulations. All right. Judy is our new champion. We got to say goodbye to Perry, but he's got a smile on his face because he's leaving with a little bundle of cash there, $350. Perry, it was a pleasure having you. Good night. Oh, you get it. Well, you think your luck is going to run out here?
No,
indeed not. She's got her $100, and she's going to have a go at the big money super match here. Shall we have a go at it?
Why not?
All right, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Lane. Oh. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, remember, then $250, and then $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Fanny.
Fanny?
Frankie Lane.
Frankie Lane is what Fanny Flagg says.
Richard.
Richard, what do you say?
The lady who was involved with, was it Superman? Lola Lane?
Lois Lane.
Oh, Lois.
Lola Lane sang with Fred Waring.
Well, God bless her for that. I'll say Lois. Sister.
You say Lois Lane. And her sister Priscilla.
And.
All right, one more.
Joanne.
Priscilla. Joanne.
You should have took me.
Or me.
I can just think of, highway Joanne. Term.
What, Clifton? Joanne.
Oh, how about Lover's Lane?
How about Lover's Lane?
Came out of the blue.
Saved by... It came out of the black is what it came out of.
It's all right. Yeah.
All right. So you
I don't
got
mind being
lane,
black,
got
but the blue is all
and
color.
You got Frankie Lane. You want to choose one of those, Judy, or give us one of your own?
I'll take Lover's Lane.
Okay, follow me. Lover's Lane. She said Lover's Lane. Is that what you said? Okay, Lover's Lane is what she said, and that's one she hopes is up there in a high position, like $500, right? Let's start at the bottom, Judy, and find out what is under the $100 response. Memory Lane. How soon they forget.
Well, she went out with Superman as well.
She went out with...
Wonderful girl.
All right, we are looking for Lover's Lane. Here's a $250 response. Abby Lane.
She also...
You all remember
Superman.
Him.
Yeah.
Okay, last chance. For Lover's Lane, here is the $500 response. Lover's Lane! Okay. Now, you got the $500. Should we try this? Okay, you're going to play for $5,000. Which one celebrity do you want to try and match?
Richard.
Okay, Richard, get ready.
Richard!
Well, I gave her Lois Lane.
Let's see if we can do it. Quiet!
He's psychic.
Bath blank. That's B-A-T-H. Bath blank. Okay, he is finished. Now, Judy, what response do you give us to match him? Bath...
Tub.
Bathtub. All right, Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Bathroom.
Bathroom. That was a hard one. Bathtub, bathroom, bathroom. Very good. Oh, all right. All right, you stand by, Judy. We're going to pass along this little message for you. Here we go. And as always, we have Gene Weber to Match Game 7. Goodbye. Thank you.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Cutman production.